You literally can't spell the word research without the word search. And in a multi-agentic system that imitates the way that we naturally perform research, where we start by defining our research objective, where we make a plan, where we gather the information and perform a search over different data sets, where we refine based on the data that we gathered and in light of the plan, and finally generate or respond with an answer, you can see that search is actually at the heart of this process. And so careful consideration must be given to its implementation. To understand how search agents are implemented today, we first have to revisit the idea of tool calling. Now, remember, LLMs by themselves can't search. They're not connected to the internet. They're not connected to databases or search APIs. So they don't have access to retrieve real-time relevant information. So tool calling is the process by which the LLM invokes these services, whether it's web or a database or an API, by virtue of an application that exposes these services as tools, where each of these tools will have a name, they'll have a definition, a tool definition, and of course they'll have some definition around the expected input. So tool calling, the LLM calls this application, and then this application connects to these services. And you can think of this database, for example, and this search API as the way that you could define or provide custom knowledge sources to your tool calling agent or tool calling LLM. Now, how the LLM does this is it sends, in response to a query, it sends a message and also a tool name to the application. Then the application routes this request, formats and routes this request to the appropriate service, comes back with data to the LLM, and then the LLM uses that data to generate an answer. Where, in the context of our research system, will be, here's what I found in response to this query or that query. Now, tool calling is very common today, and several open source frameworks make it easy to define these search tools and web tools in your app. But there are a couple of issues with this approach. So, for example, this LLM can hallucinate. So, in response to a query, when it generates this message and this tool, it could just make up a tool name for a tool that doesn't exist. And so, no tool, no data. The next thing that could happen is what I like to call poor selection. This may also be a function of the LLM, where some LLMs are better at others at function calling. And so the LLM might actually choose the wrong tool for a particular query. So it may go to the web in order to fetch information when actually it should have gone to a database or a search API for a particular query. But other times, it may be out of the LLM's control. So imagine if you had a situation where you had multiple databases and multiple search APIs defined in your application, then even the best LLM for the job could accidentally choose the wrong tool and therefore get wrong data. And then one last one that is a drawback for this approach is complexity. What do I mean by that? Well, as a data scientist or developer, you are responsible to define this application. And so if the service provider changes some of the APIs that are underlying to your tool definition in your application, then it caused the whole application to break, therefore causing your research agent to break. And so the complexities are around app maintenance. Now enter model context protocol. Or MCP for short. Think of MCP as a standardized connector for LLMs, much like how REST standardized how we make calls to web APIs. Just as REST offered a uniform way to interact with web services, MCP provides a consistent method for integrating AI models with external tools and knowledge sources. So with MCP, you have the concept of a MCP client. Where your LLM interacts with the external services through the client. Then you have the concept of a MCP server. And this MCP server connects to external services. External. Now, the kicker here is that the MCP server that connects to the external services is managed by the service provider. And then on top of this, the LLM connects through the client. It simplifies the integration that we have over here in several key ways. So the first is that you have a uniform interface. Developers no longer need to create custom integrations for each tool. MCP provides a standardized method for connecting to various external services. It's also plug and play. So similar to how USB-C offers a universal connectivity for multiple devices, MCP allows AI models to connect seamlessly and to switch between services. And that uses or takes advantage of the protocol between the client and the server called reflection. And then this all leads to trustworthiness. With MCP, LLMs are less likely to hallucinate or choose the wrong tool because now there's a standard way and protocol to parse all the tools via the client-server connection. So, search is evolving rapidly with standardized protocols like MCP. Integrating and scaling search capabilities becomes far less burdensome for developers and data scientists. So whether you're building and optimizing or simply using these systems, carefully reviewing your search strategies will be key to unlocking the full potential of AI-driven research.